25 cars in a single file lane on the outside trying to overtake the lap traffic.
Now Davey Allison goes high on the banking on the outside of Alan Kulwicki. He will clear the Kulwicki car. Now he goes to work on Ernie Irvin, but Allison stays to the high side of the banking off turn four.
Davey's still about a car length and a half back behind Ernie Irvin. The front four, though, are single file. Actually, the front five, counting Morgan Shepherd, then it is double file with Darrell Waltrip, Michael Waltrip, Alan Kulwicki, and Dale Jarrett, who started way back now, having worked his way to the front. They're back in turn one on lap 90.
Waltrip brothers clear the Alan Kulwicki car. Dale Jarrett now pulls up alongside him. It'll be the front eight cars or nine cars now on the lead lap up front, all in single file, making their way onto this back straightaway.
A little bit of break between the fifth place car of Morgan Shepherd and sixth place Darrell Waltrip now, about two, three car lengths the gap. Everybody in the front five tucked up tightly together now as they head into turn number three.
The Chevrolet of Ernie Irvin tucked in behind, in between the four Fords. Bill Elliott leading the way with Sterling Marlin second. Davey Allison looks to the inside of Ernie Irvin as they come off turn four.
Tell you what, we found out in a hurry here at Daytona, if you tuck those cars single file, you can put some daylight on the rest of the field, and that's exactly what the front five are doing. Darrell Waltrip is back in sixth. His brother Michael is seventh. Eighth right now is Dale Jarrett. Here's a battle for the lead in turn one.
Sterling Marlin dives to the inside of the racetrack alongside Bill Elliott, and Marlin flashes by with drafting help from Ernie Irvin. Marlin and Elliott go high in the banking. Here comes Irvin to the inside of the track. Three wide off turn two.
The Chevrolet underneath the two Fords. Marlin will lift for just a second. Now contact. Elliott and Irvin are together in the back straightaway. Marlin spins. He clips Darrell Waltrip. Trouble in the middle of the field. Dale Jarrett creams Marlin's car. Ken Schrader piles in. Chad Little barrels in as well. Hutch Strickland hits Jarrett. Dale Earnhardt is into the infield. All torn up. Elliott's car comes to a stop. Mark Martin is heavily damaged. Rusty Wallace has piled into the back of Chad Little's car. At least seven, eight cars, including Richard Petty, crashed into the infield grass.
And now we're seeing some flames from one car down the apron of the racetrack. A multi-car crash coming out of turn number two. And when things happen here, they happen in a hurry. Again, Sterling Marlin involved. Chad Little, apparently Kenny Schrader, also Hutch Strickland, Dale Earnhardt, Mark Martin, Rusty Wallace, and Richard Petty. Let's go back to turn three.
The car that caught fire, Barney, was Rusty Wallace's car. The flames extinguished themselves. Rusty is out of the car. The cars most seriously damaged are Ken Schrader's, Dale Jarrett's, Chad Little's, Darrell Waltrip's, and Sterling Marlin's. Rescue workers going to those cars now. Farther down into turn number three, Dale Earnhardt is backing his car away, trying to get back to the pit road. Ernie Irvin's car is stopped in the infield grass. Bobby Hillen is now climbing out of his race car in the infield. And again, Rusty Wallace's car had caught fire. The fire extinguished itself. Wallace has gotten out of that car and walked away. Again, the car is still on the back straightaway. Sterling Marlin, Dale Jarrett, Ken Schrader, who has climbed from his car now. Schrader is walking away with somewhat of a limp down the banking, but is walking away under his power. And the Chad Little car, Darrell Waltrip, has managed to fire his car. He's trying to drive back away.
Boy, you talk about taking out some top equipment in a crash. That will eliminate a lot of good race cars here this afternoon. Let's hope all the drivers are able to get out of those cars and we have no injuries in this one. Here's Mark Martin's car coming onto pit road. You can see severe damage to the front of his car. The hood is shoved up right against the windshield. Here's Dale Earnhardt with a little smoke out of his car. And we don't see any sheet metal damage on the right side of the machine, but there is some smoke trailing from Dale Earnhardt's car. Let's go to his pit.
Yeah, he's got pretty serious damage to the left front. Tires are bad. It's pushed in right at the door. But I think he's probably in pretty good shape. If it didn't knock the front end out of the line too bad, it hit right in the frame rail, right behind the left front wheel, and the rest of the car looks pretty good.
Barney out on the back straightaway, pleased to report that the last of the drivers have just climbed from their cars here at the accident scene. Sterling Marlin, Ken Schrader, Dale Jarrett, and Chad Little have all climbed from their cars and are all walking around surveying the damage.
Boy, that one happened right in the middle of the front of the pack, really, literally, so to speak. And with all those cars directly behind, there was absolutely no way, nowhere for anyone to go. And that is the reason, because when it happens like that and the field's right behind you, you're going to get seven or eight cars. Let's go back to the pits.
Waltrip just came in, and he's got about the same problem as Dale's got, except he's got it in the left rear. Rest of the car looks pretty good. They're going to go to work on the left rear, get the sheet metal pulled away from it, and it hit right in the wheel, though, so there's a good possibility they've got some damage under the car there.
I'll tell you, Davey Allison might have made the best move there, Alan Bestwick, as everybody began spinning. He very quickly went to the outside retaining wall just as Ernie Irvin and Bill Elliott and Sterling Marlin had made contact. Also, Wally Dahlenbach somehow getting through all of that mess. It's amazing how they're able to pick their spots.
Kind of replaying what I saw in the accident in my mind, Eli. Ernie Irvin had gone down underneath both Sterling Marlin and Bill Elliott to race off of turn number 2-3 wide. Now, they made it off the corner, and they were on the straightaway fine. What I think happened is I think Irvin's car and Elliott's car, maybe the two fenders, somehow hooked together, because Elliott's car kind of snapped to the left and Irvin was trying to get away from him, or they were trying to get away from each other, and they couldn't do it. And as they were trying to separate each other, that's when people began spinning and crashing together. And, yeah, those three cars first came down to the inside of the track. Allison and a couple others snuck by on the outside. Then Sterling Marlin's car snapped around to the right and went back to the outside wall. That's when it piled into the rest of the traffic. Ken Schrader and Dale Jarrett got tangled up in that against the outside wall and the other cars who crashed and spun to the inside. But it almost appeared to me like somehow Elliott and Irvin got caught together. Their cars somehow got tangled up.
Well, we see Darrell Waltrip's car going behind the wall. The Budweiser crew having a tough time pushing Bill Elliott's car. They'll go behind the wall there as well. We'll update it all for you when we come back under caution on lap 93.